Hello everyone, my name is Clarence Liu and I'm the VP of Development for Elastos. Welcome to another video of the Elastos 2020 Anniversary Series. So you may have heard from me in the last video speaking about BD and CR regions. Well, just so you know, this is the last video I'll be doing in this 10-part series, so don't worry, you'll be hearing from the other team leads shortly. The reason I'm speaking on the Elastos Ethereum sidechain is because I'm also an advisor to the Cyberpublic Ethereum Task Force, and I sort of act as a go-between between the Elastos Foundation core team that builds the Ethereum sidechain and the Ethereum Task Force that develops tools and services for the Elastos Ethereum sidechain. So in this short video, I'll be covering what the Elastos Ethereum sidechain is, roadmap and milestones, as well as adoption strategies we'll be using to track users and developers to Elastos. So what is the Elastos Ethereum sidechain? The Elastos Ethereum sidechain is one of the most important sidechains of Elastos because this is what supports smart contracts. Our sidechain is based on the Ethereum Virtual Machine and is fully compatible with Ethereum-based dApps. This makes onboarding developers very easy because most developers do already know Solidity, which is Ethereum smart contract language. Our Ethereum sidechain is unique for two primary reasons. Our DPoS pool is elected by a POW chain token ELA from our main chain. This is a massive security advantage because a separate consensus process controls minting. This is in contrast to other DPoS blockchains, where if an attacker were to gain partial control of the consensus, they may be able to mint extra tokens and then vote for themselves with that token, thus solidifying their control over the system. With Elastos, because we use hybrid auxiliary POW with Bitcoin, this is extremely difficult because the attacker would have to also attack the Bitcoin blockchain in order to successfully mint and grant themselves more votes. The other reason that we're unique is our Ethereum sidechain is going to be fully integrated with our other services, and developers will be able to access storage, identity, and more in a seamless manner where everything's all under one roof. Currently, dApp developers have to piece together different services and tools for things like storage and identity, resulting in a bit of a Frankenstein dApp with all sorts of different libraries and a large mess because they have to track different things for each of these services. With the Elastos, we hope that won't be the case because we have a very good interface and API for DIDs and storage with Hive and Carrier for communication and Elastos application as well. The Elastos Foundation core team is generally responsible for the core primary development of the Ethereum sidechain. So anything that's intrinsic to the running of the Ethereum sidechain, such as the software, the infrastructure, the maintenance, is handled by them. The Cyberpublic Funded Ethereum Task Force, and hopefully many more teams in the future, is made of community members who work with EF to build non-essential tooling and services for the Elastos Ethereum sidechain. So this includes external services that support DeFi, like oracles or token bridges that all help with user onboarding. For our roadmap and milestones, the Elastos core team and Ethereum Task Force will both work hand in hand to ensure that all of our work complements each other. For the Elastos core team, by end of October, we hope to have full DPoS consensus done. And then we also hope to have the EVM version upgrade to Constantinople, where currently it's on an older version called Byzantium. We also expect that the Elastos team will have full Ethereum support in their application and wallet, as well as their plugins. On the Ethereum Task Force side, one of our first priorities is building ElaMask, which is a browser extension similar to MetaMask that we'll be using just for our ecosystem. By the end of the year, we are looking at improved block time proposals that could improve the performance of the Ethereum sidechain. We believe this is paramount to maintaining our competitiveness in the growing Ethereum space. We also expect on the Ethereum Task Force that by end of 2020, we'll have the token bridges, money markets, and other DeFi basic components ready to go. Early next year, on the Ethereum Task Force, we'll be pushing for Ethereum sidechain security audits. This is important to instill confidence in outside investors to move their assets to Elastos. We also will be expecting that the Elastos core team will continue to fine-tune and ready a production launch for the Elastos mainnet once everything is done, as well as security audits. This will be a new marketing push that hopefully we can have early 2021. As for DeFi, one of our initial goals at the Ethereum Task Force is to build a small proof of concept which will allow CR proposal funds to be collateralized and ELA DAI to be withdrawn. So ELA DAI is a stablecoin, so it's perfectly fine for proposers and developers to spend that ELA DAI upfront. Only when they are complete and the benefit to the Elastos ecosystem is realized do they receive the remainder of the funds. This is also a great project because it can be open sourced and it will demonstrate the basic functionality of DeFi. So this scheme will require things like oracles and money markets, which we'll all have to develop. One of the primary ways we want to drive adoption for the Elastos Ethereum sidechain is to work on a product called ElaMask. ElaMask will be similar to MetaMask, except it will be tailored for the Elastos Ethereum network. Now, currently, MetaMask does work with the Elastos Ethereum sidechain, but MetaMask is more commonly associated with Ethereum, and also it's extremely poor UX because when users have to switch between Ethereum dApps and Elastos dApps, they have to switch the network in their MetaMask plugin, which is extremely jarring. By having a separate ElaMask extension, Elastos dApps will automatically open the ElaMask extension instead of the MetaMask extension and automatically connect to the Elastos network. This will be a much smoother interface for users. Also, ElaMask will support ELA cross-chain transfers, allowing new users to more easily get their hands on ELA-FSC, which is the equivalent of Ethereum on our Ethereum sidechain, which is used for gas for most of the dApps. Finally, as a top-tier project, we believe that Lasso should create our own product for dApp usage. This will improve our recognition, image, and reputation to the rest of the blockchain community. Another way we want to drive adoption is through building token bridges. It's imperative to connect our Ethereum sidechain to the wider DeFi ecosystem. We're now seeing massive adoption by other blockchain products to embrace DeFi as well. They're also all building bridges themselves. The Elastos Ethereum Task Force will work on the token bridge as part of a larger stablecoin and money market project that is on Cyberpunk. Another thing we have to look at attracting is yield farming. Even if we build the bridges are not worth anything unless we have something on our side of the bridge on Elastos to track the financial assets to move over here. The things that we can build on our side in our ecosystem are things like staking pools that allow you to earn a return on investment on your stablecoins, cross-chain DEXs, or collateralized loan platforms that allow users to borrow and lend money, which would be very cool if we can create a way for people to earn reputation points through their Elastos DID, for example, and increase an Elastos type credit score and borrow money from other people for a set interest rate. The key here is as long as the interest rates for lenders is higher than other blockchain projects, we'll be able to track yield farming. For more information on DeFi, you can visit crregions.com, where there's a dedicated page for DeFi. So here's kind of a small roadmap snapshot from our website. We'll be updating this regularly with the projects and progress of the projects we're working on. Thanks for listening. And as you can see, we are still a little bit of a ways off from having a fully functional Ethereum sidechain, but we expect to get there early 2021. Thank you.